Oh, I got a good one here for you today. I got a special guest here on the Pickin show today. I got two special guests. Anyway, both of them are named John. One of them is named John Cowan. Another one is John McFee. Hey, if you watch the Pickin with Jamie Walker, I'm sure John Cowan is not a name that you have not heard before, because we play that a whole lot. And those of you who watch the Thursday show, I'm sure you've heard me play a little bit of Doobie Brothers from time to time. Well, I've got two people who are connected with all of these, and it's just awesome to be here tonight. They just finished their concert, we're backstage, and it is just wonderful to include this on the show today. And I'm so honored that these guys could come and be on the show today. John and John, I'm so glad that you could be on the show today.
Thank you, Jamie.
And before I get started, I want to swell both your heads here for a moment.
Okay.
John, so now I'm have to say both your names so I can keep everybody straight. John Cowan.
Yes, sir.
I'll tell you, you know, somebody was talking to me the other day, and I was trying to explain to them about your music, and they really wasn't familiar. They've lived under a rock or something. And so I tried to describe how you sing, and I said that John Cowan sings like an eagle. Sings like an eagle. And I said, he'll get up this really high note at the top of the theater and just hover and then swoop down into the audience. And that's the way you sing. And I think it's awesome. And the very first time I ever started playing music, I was with a little band, and we played China Grove. And so both of you guys have
your band obviously had excellent taste.
Excellent taste.
I commend and I
really feel like that you know, both of you guys have meant a whole lot to me in my appreciation of music, and I'm so honored to be able to talk with you here today. And so I guess I'm going to start with you, John Cowan.
Okay.
The Pickin has to do a whole lot with bluegrass. And with bluegrass, I don't think that there is any group that has changed the landscape of bluegrass more than the Newgrass Revival. And I think it's really interesting, you know, when you started with Newgrass Revival, I think you had been doing stuff with Ebo Walker.
No, he was the bass player before me.
Well,
so they started, yeah. When the band started, it was Courtney Johnson.
Yeah.
Sam Bush, Curtis Birch, and Ebo Walker.
Uh-huh.
So he subsequently left the band, and a gentleman from Radford, Virginia, named Butch Robbins, who's actually a wonderful banjo player,
mm-hmm.
He played bass for just a little bit with them, and then I was the next guy that took Butch's place, and then I was there from 1974 till Newgrass Revival disbanded in 1990.
Yeah. It's kind of interesting. You really didn't have a bluegrass background, did you?
No, I did not. I didn't really know any, other than owning the Will the Circle Be Unbroken album, I didn't I didn't really know anything about it. It's funny because I grew up in Kentucky, in Louisville, probably because I lived in the city, but I was just a rock and roll kid playing in high school bands.
Right. Well, now, on the flip side of that, John McFee, you know, I did not know that you were such a wonderful country musician. I was really impressed with your steel guitar playing tonight.
Thank you very much.
And I'm thinking about the Doobie Brothers. I just didn't get my picture of you playing the steel guitar and doing country music. But you're no stranger to country music at all. How are you?
Well, I grew up, you know, my dad played, and that's why I started playing. I was, you know, before I could walk, really, and instruments were around the house, and he played country music, and that's what he listened to, and that's all I heard when I was growing up.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up, I'm a native Californian, and people go, well, then what, country music, California? Well, there's a guy named Merle Haggard, who's also a native Californian.
Yeah.
I grew up in the same musical culture and culture overall that I did, the oil field culture, the people that have come out in the Dust Bowl years and things like that from, you know, South and all kinds, all over the place, really. But country music was really big, and I grew up listening to and playing country. And then when the Beatles came out, everybody wanted to have a band. I was like, hey, that McFee kid already knows how to play. Let's get him in our band. So I kind of like snuck into rock and roll.
Yeah.
That's how it happened for me.
Well, now, what's interesting about that is that you, John, didn't really have a bluegrass or country background, mm-hmm. and you did, and your genres were sort of like reversed.
Well, we're like, that's why we, I think, make a pretty good team.
Yeah.
We kind of have, from opposite sides, we've ended up sort of in the same place.
Well, now, John Cowan, I think you played with the Doobie Brothers starting in 1993?
I think it was 92, 93, and a little bit of 1994. I was there just a little over, close to 3 years the first time.
Well, I think that the way you got in with the Doobie Brothers is your friendship with John.
Actually, that is not how it happened.
Oh, well, please enlighten me, sir.
It didn't hurt.
Now, we had met, as I said, on stage tonight in the mid-80s in Nashville. So I was really aware of John McFee and his musicianship, as it were. I actually got the Doobies because myself, Rusty Young from Poco, and Bill Lloyd from Foster and Lloyd had a band with Patrick Simmons called the Sky Kings, and we were signed to RCA Records. Mm-hmm. And we were working on this record, and about that time, the Doobies kind of got reactivated and had some shows, and the guy that had been playing for them, a gentleman by the name of Willie Weeks, he had taken a job when the Doobies kind of became dormant there for a little period of time. He took a job with Wynonna Judd. So he wasn't available, and the Doobies had some dates on the books. And Pat asked me if I wanted to go play bass, and I was like, of course, when do we leave? And so he kind of ushered me into the band. He just said, I know we got these dates, and we need a bass player. I know this guy. I'm playing in a band with him. He's really good, and he sings well. And now John already knew
although
me.
I voted against it.
Just kidding. So anyway, that's how that happened.
Well, you know, the Doobies are anything but dormant now. You're telling me that they're going on tour now. You know, tell me a little bit about the tour coming up.
Yeah, sure. We've been busy for the last since
37
when
years.
John started with us the first time.
Mm-hmm. 93. Yeah,
and we've been pretty active since then, doing about 80 shows a year or more.
Wow.
And but we're going to probably even get busier because right now we've got a new project that we did. It's a Nashville-based project, actually, where collaboration with a bunch of country artists doing the Doobie Brothers classic songs, Blackwater, China Grove, mm-hmm. and music, etc. But we've got, like, you know, Brad Paisley, Chris Young, Toby Keith, Zach Brown Band, a bunch of really great people doing these songs with us, and that's going to be coming out, so we'll be pretty busy.
Let's talk about this new project.
And John Cowan's on the record.
Oh, wow. Let's talk about this new project, 60. You just celebrated your 60th birthday.
Well, actually, just six. We finished the record. We were finishing the record when I celebrated my 60th birthday.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
And so, 60 is the name of the album, and it you know, it's a reflection of you looking back over your life. There's a lot of cool tunes on there. A lot of cool people on there. Sam Bush, Alison Krauss. You know, did I read those album credits? Is Huey Lewis really doing something on that album?
Yeah, he plays harmonica on the song we did earlier called Sugar Baby.
Oh, really?
A Jesse Colin Young song.
Yeah.
Huey's an old bandmate of mine. Before I joined the Doobies, Huey and I had a band together for about 10 years.
Yeah,
and,
really?
I kind of dragged him in. I played on a couple of their records, too.
Oh, that's cool.
Huey Lewis in the News. But.
So, yeah, this record is loaded with guests. Chris Hillman. From the Birds and Desert Rose Band, and he was a member of the Flying Burrito Brothers, amazing musician, singer. I could start, it would take me a long time to tell you who else is on the record. Leon Russell's on the record, Sam Bush is on the record, Rodney Crowell's on the record, I think I mentioned Jim Messina's on the record.
John Jorgensen,
Victor Krauss, Alison Krauss's amazing brother, who's an amazing upright bass player. Who else? Who am I leaving off?
Ray Benson. Yeah, Josh Williams.
Ray Benson from Asleep at the Wheel.
Mm-hmm. And,
we're just going to forget.
It's hard to.
Wow.
And there was a reason in each case, actually. It's not just this thing, well, let's get everybody we can think of. It was more like, hey, what if we had so and so? And we're lucky enough, John and I have been around long enough. We have a lot of musical friends.
Ed Toth, who played with us tonight, who's a member of the Doobies. Guy Alson, an amazing keyboard player from the Doobies. Mark Russo, just outstanding saxophone player.
Tony Pia, our other drummer.
Actually, the only Doobie Brothers that aren't on the record are Tommy and Pat. And that was just an accident. It really wasn't. Anyways.
Let's see, John McFee, I understand that you produced the John Cowan's album.
I did.
So how did that happen?
Well, he made that mistake of asking me, and he didn't wise up in time. No, you know, we've been playing together a bunch, through the years and known each other. And he came to me and said, he'd heard some stuff I'd produced, like a Carlin Carter record or some other things, I guess. And so thought it might be a good fit. And he asked me about it. And I said, yeah, sure. I mean, it was really, honestly, totally in all honesty, it was such an honor to be asked to produce John Cowan.
Wow.
He's not a finer singer on the planet.
That's really good, and I've noticed, in watching the show tonight, you guys really have a good rapport on stage, and that band of yours is just awesome. Mm-hmm. I mean, you got some really good pickers. I mean,
yeah,
really.
it's like a mini orchestra because each of them seem to play 3 to 4, 5 instruments.
Wow.
So it's crazy.
That, you know, that really is something cool. And you know, you mentioned this. I want to pop on this real quick. There's most of the time when you see somebody that is the lead singer in a band, they're either playing guitar or keyboard. You're a bass player and you're playing and singing lead. I mean, that is really unusual. Did you start out playing bass or do you play other instruments?
Yeah, it's that's the instrument I started. And it was just because, well, for one, I love the Beatles and I'm Paul McCartney freak. But the other thing is that in my first band that I had in my neighborhood, there was a drummer and a guitar player and another guitar player. And they said, well, you play the bass. I went, okay. And actually, my first bass was an electric guitar that I used a quarter as a pick on. And I just played on the bottom 3-4 strings. So once I got semi-serious about it, my dad took me down to a pawn shop in Louisville and bought me my first bass.
Wow. And it looks like it's the same one.
Well, that bass, yeah, that would have been 1967 or 68. Now, my bass was made in 62. I bought it the second year I was in Newgrass Revival. So I bought that bass in 75. It was made in 1962. It looks like it, yeah. My mom always used to say, honey, can't you get a new bass?
No, it's not the same. John McFee, you play a lot of instruments. How many instruments do you play?
Usually one at a time.
One at a time. I like that.
I've been asked that so much, and I should probably try to figure out at some point.
Yeah.
Most string instruments, like on John's record, I'm playing, of course, acoustic and electric guitar, pedal steel, dobro, violin, mandolin, banjo. I don't know what else, but, most string instruments, that's the main thing. And in the Doobies, I also play harmonica. But it's, wow. I don't know. I never really...
Never counted.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to end it up here. I just want to what's going to be new for you guys? What are you guys going to do together in the near future? You've got any plans?
Well, we're going to continue to do this, mm-hmm. do this band to promote this record 60. Mm-hmm. Doobies have a pretty real full schedule for the next year, of course.
How do you make that work, the two of you, with the two bands being
as
active?
Best we can.
Yeah.
Well, basically what we do is when the Doobie Brothers are not working, we do this if we can. It just makes for two very busy people.
Yeah. Well, John and John, awesome. I am so thankful that you guys took time. I know you're tired. You did an awesome show, and now I'm bugging you with a bunch of questions. But I really want to tell you, it means a lot to me to have you guys on the show and for you to sit here and chat with me. Thank you so much.
You're
for
very
being
welcome, Jamie. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.